vacation too. The best I can do. But it's absolutely not true. Mr. Glennie knows it. Mr. Giordino absolutely knows it. It was not a miscommunication. We were clear as a bell. We are not, we don't suffer from inarticulation. We told Mr. Giordino exactly what we wanted. We wanted information on the phone. We wanted everything that they had about the phone, and we wanted the phone itself. And his comment to us, it is not in our care, custody, and control. There's no other way to parse that. And I don't make these points lightly. It is not fun for me. This is not enjoyment for me. I don't like having to discuss an active misrepresentation by the people, by the Commonwealth, on behalf of the government. I think it's outrageous, I think it's unjustified, and it's not fun. But it's also inherently not fair to us. And so Mr. Glennie's comments, he's doing the best he can to call it a miscommunication. There was no miscommunication. This was an active misrepresentation, and it should never, ever be tolerated, ever, especially on behalf of the government.
But what your motion boils down to at this point is that the Trudeau issue is off the table. What you're looking for is the phone.
Correct.
That's what this all boils down to, is you want the phone.
And at this point, given what we now know, and by the way, Mr. Glennie also says, well, they've got what they wanted. They've got this forensic extraction. They've got what they wanted. That's not true. Number one, we already know, and Mr. Glennie already knows, and he should be concerned that his extraction report is inaccurate. It is not an accurate representation of what's on that phone. How do we know that? Because of the group texts. There were group texts that they have in their file that don't exist in the extraction report. He knows that, I know that. So now we can all agree. Let's stop dancing around. We can all agree the extraction report is inaccurate. It has been manipulated. It has been, there have been deletions on it. All right, not by the government. That's not an accusation that we're making, but certainly by Heather Unruh or Will Little or both. So we need two things, Your Honor. I want the actual forensic download, which is not the extraction report from the download, but the actual forensic download. Colloquially, it's called a mirror image. I want the mirror image that Mr. Glennie and Mr. Giordino have currently in their possession. They do have that. Either them or at their crime lab, they've got it. Number two, the second thing I want is the actual phone. I'm entitled to go to the source data to find out what was or was not deleted, and that's what we're seeking. Those two things as it relates to the phone. The third thing is I want the same information as it pertains to Heather Unruh's phone. Now, I don't have a good faith belief that they've ever done an extraction of Heather Unruh's phone, so I don't think that that exists or that they have it. So I would ask for her phone, for my expert to be able to do that forensic download or mirror image so that we can then pull an accurate forensic extraction report from that phone as well. That's what we're asking for. That's what we're entitled to.
Respect to that request, as Glennie indicated, I denied that request initially, and I know you want me to reconsider it.
I understand.
I'll take another look at it. I decide that there's enough to pursue it, it would have to be a further hearing. They would have a chance to come in and argue
against
it.
That's fine. That's fine. We accept that.
I understand. Okay. Just so we're clear about it.
Yeah, I'm not trying to sort of overstep process. I get that there's a process.
Yeah. All right. Fine. Thank you.
The last thing that I'll suggest to the court is as to the issue of timing. I brought this up at the last hearing. I'd like to address it again.
Sure.
Mr. Spacey is entitled to his speedy trial. Period and amen. What he is suffering every day that this goes on, every single day, there are cameras in the courtroom today, there are reporters populating the courthouse, every day that this goes on without resolution is a day that he suffers. That's a day that he's not getting justice. That's a day that he's not getting his due process. The shenanigans that have been going on the government's side are outrageous, they're unjustified. They're inexcusable. And we shouldn't have to suffer the ills of having to come back over and over and over. And every time we come back, we get something new and revelatory. There's a new revelation every single time we come back to this courthouse. That is not fair. That's not how the government should be conducting its investigation. That's not how it should be preparing for trial. If they weren't ready to go to trial on the day they filed this case, they shouldn't have filed it. And I submit they absolutely shouldn't have. This is a ridiculous case, and they shouldn't have filed it to begin with. But they did it. They unlocked that barn door, and now the horse is out. And they've got to go to trial. We're entitled to that. More importantly, Mr. Spacey's entitled to that. One of the things that I found just, it'd be amusing if it weren't so sad. In response to the motion that we filed, Michael O'Keefe, the DA, the sitting DA for the Cape and Islands DA's office, was confronted by a reporter who said, what do you think about these accusations concerning, and the allegations concerning your office and misrepresentations that your office had made? His response was, if Mr. Spacey was not who he is, no one would care about this case. I know I learned a term in law school, gobsmacked. I was taken aback by that statement. That was ridiculous. For the sitting district attorney of this county to say if he wasn't who he is, nobody would care about this case. What is he saying? What's the translation? If it wasn't Mr. Spacey, he never would have filed the case? Is that the translation? Or is the translation, if it weren't Mr. Spacey, nobody would know about these misrepresentations. Nobody would know about holding back evidence because nobody would litigate this to the extent that we are. If they're not ready to go to trial, they shouldn't have filed the case. And if they think nobody cares about this case, my response would be to the Commonwealth, I'll tell you who cares about this case. We care about this case. Mr. Fowler, Mr. Spacey cares about this case. The people of Nantucket, they care about this case. If they don't care about it, so be it. God bless them. But we do, and we want a trial. And we're ready to go to trial. If this court were to grant us an expeditious discovery order today or in the coming week, I promise you, Judge, we will act expeditiously, equally expeditiously, to get ready. No matter what that information is that comes to us, we just need the time to download it, analyze it, and then we're ready for trial. And we don't want to wait till October or November. We think we're entitled to a trial within 8 weeks or so.
Won't happen.
Why won't it happen, Judge?
The way things work here, and I appreciate that you're unfamiliar with them, is we have jury trials here every other month. That's why I'm here this week. We'll have jury trials this week. The next trial session will be in August. There is a trial assignment date that occurs before that, and at that point, I set up the trials for that particular week.
Okay.
So again, this week, August, October, December. This case, I would expect, is not going to be able to be tried in one of the normally assigned jury weeks. I'm going to have to find separate space on the calendar to accommodate this case. Because, as you indicated that...
Sorry, Judge.
It's all right. You indicated that you thought it was going to carry on for 2 weeks. Maybe it will be because of the celebrity that attaches to it, the difficulties in selecting a jury. Maybe. I don't know. But the actual trial of these cases, you know, similar such cases, will take, you know, maybe 2 days, maybe 3 days. It's not that complicated, at least from the court's perspective at that point.
I agree.
In any event, I need to find, you know, there are several other courts that use this space, the probate court, the superior court, the juvenile court, etc. So I need to be able to carve out that piece of time, and we're going to need to bring in more jurors than is normal. If you're lucky, I'm not being flip, if we're lucky, because I want to get the case tried too. I appreciate that it's a burden on him. But then again, you know, every other defendant, and if you get in the queue, there are many ahead of you. It's likewise a burden to them, and some are in custody to have their case tried. So, you know, I'm disinclined to let Mr. Fowler step in front of those people, except that there are considerations that need to be addressed in terms of a separate week.
And that's what I would ask, if the court could accommodate us in August, even late August.
No. It can't. First of all, you know, to try this case, I mean, it's difficult enough to get accommodations on this island anytime in June, July, and August. It would be impossible to get this case tried.
I'll stay in a tent.
I'm glad to know that. But
I get accommodations are lax, but we'll make do, Judge.
I appreciate it. But, you know, we have the issue of the jurors, as I say, we need to... We need to be able to summons them. That requires at least 90 days, et cetera. So it's just not an easy thing to accommodate. And as I say, Mr. Fowler, as much as I'd like to get his case tried for a variety of reasons, among them so that that we can all move on to the next case, whatever, he's still one of the individuals who is in the queue. And I'll do the best I can, as I'm sure the Commonwealth will, to move this case along. It's not happening in August. Whether it can happen in October, November, remains to be seen. But that's what you're looking at. Go ahead.
May I have just a moment?
Sure.
My co-counsel reminds me that, and I just want to bring this to the court's attention. I don't want to, the horse is, if it's not dead, it's on its last leg, and I don't want to beat it. But the court did indicate at our last, and this is new procedure to me, the court indicated at our last hearing that there's a possibility that the court might have, which is to set aside a special panel that's sort of outside the bracketed timeframes that the court might accommodate. If the court could at least consider that.
But even if, and I am going to do that because
okay.
I'm not going to interrupt, do the best I can not to interrupt, you know, the flow of cases
right.
on this island. So I'm going to have to pick a separate space
okay.
of time. But that still requires that we bring in jurors. That can't happen overnight. So again, consider the horse dead with respect to a trial in August. So
I was hoping you weren't going to say that.
Oh, sorry.
All right, Judge. All right. I appreciate you at least listening.
Sure.
Thank you. Submitted.
All right. Anything else, folks, from anybody, Mr. Glenn?
No.
Yes, I feel I need to address a couple of things. One is really kind of a housekeeping matter, and I'm not sure this wasn't intentional, but there was a mention made of the Officer Kelly, and he was referred to as a state police trooper, and that he's not.
He's not.
He's a Nantucket police officer.
That's my mistake.
Right.
Thank you.
And then, Jan, I would suggest that the Commonwealth, as I stated in the opposition, categorically denies that there was any affirmative, conscious misrepresentation at any time made by ADA Giardina.
I understand.
And then secondly, Your Honor, there was a suggestion concerning about a media quote by Mr. O'Keefe. Now, I've had an opportunity to speak to him actually about that, and he was talking about the media, that the media wouldn't care if this was anybody else besides Mr. Spacey. Not that the people or the parties wouldn't care, but the media. And I think the court has seen that this is not the typical case in terms of the media interest. Not that there's anything wrong with the media being interested, but they are interested, and they're here hanging on every word. And I address the media in my submission, Your Honor, and I would just ask that you take a close look at that. Thank you.
Thanks, gentlemen. Lee, I appreciate it. I did indicate in my ruling that we could perhaps have a further pretrial if we're going to have one. Be a video conference, if that would be helpful, I'm sure, to you, if, as long as we could orchestrate it. I would like an affidavit from your expert, if you
we'll
can
take
do
care
that
of that
as quickly as possible. That would be helpful.
Tomorrow.
Do you want to pick a further date at this point? If you want to pick a further date in July via video conference, if there's some other date that works, what's your pleasure, folks?
May I have just a second to
sure.
consult with counsel? I'm just consulting my calendar, which is on my phone, Your Honor. Thank you.
And you can likewise talk to the Commonwealth and see what works for them as well. Again, Mondays and Wednesdays during the summer, we are here, so.
Mondays and Wednesdays, got it.
How about the 15th, July 15th? Yeah, that works for me. Mike, July 15th. 1 week ago, I'm available.
Okay.
Is fine. It is okay.
Your Honor, Monday the 8th seems to work with all of our calendars if it works with the court's calendar.
The 8th of July?
Yes, Your Honor.
Sure. Okay. Let's put it on for that date. And is it your desire to have a video conference, or do you want to actually?
If I could discuss that with my client.
Why don't you do that between counsel. Now and then? Just let the court know sufficiently in advance so we can make sure that if it's going to be video conference, the connection works, et cetera. So,
excuse
go
me.
Ahead. Yes.
Your Honor, yes. So if the court will allow me that latitude, I'll discuss with my client and counsel if we'd like to do it by video conference or actually make it an appearance. You're going to be here either way, correct?
I will.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
No,
appreciate
thank you.
That.
One more thing, by the way. There was a response from the club car, which I don't know, do you have it? It indicates
yes.
There is no surveillance. So.
I've spoken to Mr. Wilson. He very kindly indicated that. He's filed a significant amount of paperwork suggesting that. I've got no issue with that, and,
right.
and we'll submit on that issue.
Thank you. Okay.
Thank you.
All right. All right, folks, thank you very much for your appearance here today and your arguments. I'll take it under advisement and hopefully can, as I say, issue a ruling later on this week, but I do want to see that affidavit.
We'll get it to you by the close of business tomorrow.
I appreciate it.
Thank
All right,
you.
Folks, thanks again. I'm going to step off so the camera can break down and people can leave who are connected with this case. I'll come back out. We'll deal with the other matters. All right, thanks.
This case is...